Hello everyone, excuse the furnace kicking on, but what you're looking at here today is my 52 inch Hunter original in flat black. I got this fan from Jack Miner as a late Christmas gift. It uses the American made oil bath motor with the 4-5 lay rotor. The motor is rated at 2.0 amps, 3 speed pull chain ran by speed coils, and is electrically reversible. So I'll go ahead and show you the close ups. Got the included walnut blades, reversible to oak, 2.5 downrod. This fan was manufactured on February 14, 2002, made in the production plant line number 130. Not sure if you can see that, but it is here. From the Lyndhurst. Yay. I'm so glad that it did. We're going to start off with the 4-blade configuration. We'll begin in with the light. As you can see, this is a 3-way pull chain. So this goes 2. This is the second 2. This is all 4. I'm using 4 EcoSmart R20 50 watt equivalent LED bulbs. Those are daylight and they bright up the room pretty well. Considering the fact that using the R20 style bulbs. So we're going to demonstrate the fan starting off low. The fan's mounted really well, so it's not going to fall. Low speed is kind of a bit fast, but I'm fine with it. It's on a wall control, so it handled really well on low and medium. It is full on oil, so I just thought say this right away before you guys give me a lot of crap. Alright, that's about for low. Here's medium. With the 3-speed originals, they always have a really good big speed difference on medium speed between low and medium. So this is performing like a KP5 type fan. Thank you. But for me, Nyhurst High. Now, this is a really serious airflow killer on high speed, especially being a 2.0 amp fan. It puts out tons of air like most originals do. Shut off, we'll do spin down. Now, this is a Texas fan. And how do you know that it's a Texas fan? Is that if you're seeing more of its rotor on the bottom of the faceplate, that's a Texas fan. Texas did play by their own rules, so you're seeing a lot more of its rotor. Spin down is going quite long since I filled it up with oil fully. And this fan is operated off of a Leviton fan light control that was on there since New Year of 2015. It was able to handle low and medium. It did provide it a good meme speed instead of a fast one. That's good. And this fan is one of the best airflow killers in the house. Finally, the spotlight is gloss black, but I don't really care. As long as it's in black, that's what matters. So I'll go ahead and reverse it. We'll start off with low. Alright, that's about for low. Here's medium.
up for medium. Now here's high. It is more wobbly in reverse,
but not that much as in on downdraft. But I mount the fan properly well, so it shouldn't fall. Apologize for the AC to kick on. Shut it off, we'll do a spin down. This fan had its blade arms scratched, so I repainted it. And I also did repainted the switch housing too. Yeah, I also do apologize for the lighting. I just got home from school. But I just can't get over how excited I felt to dethrone the Lyndhurst. Finally, after almost 7 years of going through lower end fans, this finally happened.
I am so glad
I was able to change out the Lyndhurst for this fan, the true performance beast. Finally, I'm really glad. I really am excited. I may, at some point, do a video of this fan on the Leviton 3-speed fan light control to show you that it handles low and medium pretty well. Alright, so that's about it with the 4-blade configuration. Now I'll go ahead and demonstrate it with 5 blades.
Alright, now here it is with the 5-blade configuration.
I repainted the blade arms, the downrod, switched out in some of the parts of the faceplate as it had some scratches on it. This is not the original light kit. It originally had a genuine 103 light fitter, but it was painted badly black, so I asked for a cap because it's like it's too dang cool to not use it. We'll go ahead and begin the demonstration with the fan, starting off with the light. There's two. You have a 2. There's all 4. Go ahead and demonstrate the fan starting off with flow.
That's above a low. Here's medium. Medium, now here's high. Five blades, it still moves tons of air, but then again, four blades actually moves more air than five. One is because of less motor drag, two, more blade spacing, three, better efficiency, and four, better ab movement. Shut it off, we'll do a spin down. I will say it's way more cleaner with five blades in a circle instead of four as a square. But that doesn't mean five is going to have better air movement than four. It's all about the looks. And I'll also definitely say that this is a 2.0 amp original, so with 5 blades, it can outperform the 1.1 amp overseas 1 amp, 2.5 amp, and the 1.9 amp originals. This is by far the most powerful fan in the house. As a result, that the Lindhurst is down, I'm finally glad I'm able to make this happen. And this is my favorite achievement of this year. Originally, I wanted to swap the box for a fan-rated one, but that box did not fit. So my dad did not want to make any more mess, so he decided to keep using that existing box and drill holes for a U-bolt. I mean, I'm kind of disappointed, but at the same time, it's not on a electrical box of ears, so it's on its own U-bolt. We'll ahead and reverse it. Let's start off with low. Alright, that's buff low. Here's medium. That's about for me and no, here's how I actually forgot. I'll go ahead and turn it off. We'll do a spin down. I love
everything, how it looks with the spotlight kit, even though the spotlight kit is gloss black. Funny story is that when I was going to put five blades on it, I was going to turn it on to see if it works, and the motor was buzzing, and I was like, okay, what the heck is going on? So I flipped the reverse switch, and behold, it works on downdraft again. I was questioning myself, what the heck is up with the humming noise? Thankfully, it still works. If it didn't, I would have been really upset 100%. And once again, thank you, Jack Miner, for this fan if you're watching this. I'm really excited to have a boat anchor in the living room. And it felt like a tank. So that's about it with my 52-inch Hunter Original in flat black. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video.